What's going on, y'all? It is me, your host, Louis B. I am back with another check-in. This time around, I want to do something a little different. If you notice, I've been trying to tap into some different areas, you know what I'm saying? I tapped in with my rappers, I tapped in with a barber even. Now I feel like doing something a little different. I want to tap in with a dancer, you know what I'm saying? I want somebody to put me on a little something. So I have special guest, Daja. Speak to him.
Hey, y'all, what's going on?
How you feeling today? You good?
I'm feeling amazing. God is good, and I'm just happy to be here. What is up, A-Town?
Oh, shit, A-Town represent. Listen, I love people that's born and raised here, you know what I'm saying? This is really what I want to do with checking in. It's really about highlighting the talented people that live here. Like, we have so much talent here. I know you got the New Yorks, you got the LAs, but my nigga, it's so much talent in Atlanta, Georgia alone. And I promise you, I'm gonna try and find all you niggas. I'm gonna try to find all you niggas. So let's go ahead and get started, man. Actually, I wanna start a little different because I ain't gonna cap to you, you know what I'm saying? When I do, I try to do my research on my people before I get my people in. I always think it's good to be well researched. So, okay. So I went to your IG page.
Okay.
I went all the way to the bottom.
Oh, okay.
just to see, man. I'm inquisitive. So I went all the way to the bottom of your page and I found a gem. It was actually, I'll show it here, but it was a fortune and a fortune cookie that you got. Mm-hmm. Real interesting. It said you will always be successful at your professional career. Seeing things like that, how does that make you feel now, seeing where you're at now?
It's alignment. It's crazy. Like, it really is. Like, it's crazy how I even opened that fortune and it said that, and at the time I wasn't even doing it. I wasn't even back dancing the way how I should be. And just to see where I am now is just like, you actually doing that shit. Like, you actually doing it. And this is just the surface. This ain't even got to where it's gonna actually be yet. So I've always knew that. Like, I know that God put me here to dance. Like, that's what he put inside of me. Like, it's not on me, it's in me. You know what I'm saying? So
what was going on 9 years ago? Because normally when I meet dancers, they've mm-hmm. been doing this shit since they could walk. Okay. Like, you start walking, you dancing. So I guess you're saying that 9 years ago you weren't dancing as hard as you was now, you weren't taking it as seriously?
No. So let me go back. So basically what I'm trying to say is at that time, I was not dancing consistently. I was in college.
Okay.
So
gotcha.
That's what I was doing. So I started at the age of 11. That's when my professional dance career started. But like, dancing since the womb. Like, been dancing since
before
the womb.
I got out.
Like, I've been dancing since knee high. So it just became professional. It became a triple effect after 11 years old. So.
So what was that change at 11? You kind of was like, all right, man, I can do me a little crazy 1-2 step. Nah, you know what I'm saying? Let's get in some classes. Let's get in some groups. Let's see
well,
what we can do.
Like my mom was like my momager. So she made sure that I was on top of everything. Like, so after school, I was going straight to the dance studio. Mm-hmm. I was there from day to night, every day, taking workshops, meeting new people, just getting all I could get in. So from 11 all the way up until probably like my senior year in high school. And then that's when things started to, like, I got into other things in life. You know what I'm saying? Who doesn't? I got into life, I got into boys.
Makes sense.
You know what I'm saying? My mom wasn't a hard parent that just told you, oh no, you can't do this. She let me live, you know? So I think it always been a part of me, even though I had stopped after high school, it had always been a part of me. So just getting back to it and being so consistent like I am now is just a blessing. The fact that I still got all my limbs, everything's still working, everything is still everything, but.
Listen, you saying your limbs still working, fam.
Yes, because I'm getting old.
I'm getting up with some back pains from a mattress. And I'm just like, fuck, and I'm only 26. This is some bullshit, man.
Yes, so my knees be cracking, but that's always been like that. It don't have nothing to do with no age, but yes, that's how far it goes back. It goes back since a child to going into this industry. Like, I met plenty of great people, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, resume is pretty long.
We gonna get into it. So continuing on with the timeline, so I guess what was that defining moment that made you say, hey, and this is probably like adulthood now, so after college, the wake up call of dance is exactly what the fuck I wanna do, like for real.
So recently, I wanna say, I've been consistent back into dance for about a year, going on a year and a half. So probably like a year, like 5 months, maybe a year and a half just yet. So I got out of something that was just really toxic, and I started getting back into me, started getting back to make what makes me happy. And I was working a job and I didn't like the job. Like, I was just working, you know what I'm saying, just to, you know, because I had got a raise, paying good. It was getting shit done.
Yeah.
But that's not where I wanted to be. So my best friend will always say, I can't wait till you quit that job. And really pursue what you love to do, you know what I'm saying? So that's always scary, to quit your job and just...
Tell me about it.
Get out here and just go for it. You know, when you know you still got the bills you gotta pay.
Jesus.
So it was like, one day I was like, F it. Like, I'm tired, I don't wanna be here no more. I kept getting signs after sign. And I'm very in tune with my spiritual, with God. So I know when, okay, he talking to me and I don't need to keep ignoring it, you know? So September 3rd, 2021 was my last day working my job, my 9-to-5 job. I quit.
Oh shit, this is like this year.
Yeah, and
wow.
It was just what it was, because I ain't have time to keep wasting. I don't have time to keep wasting. Time is ticking. And I gotta show the world my gifts and my talents. That's what I'm here to do. So it's just like, I feel so much better now. Like, I get up and do what I love to do. Like, I get up and make my own schedule, you know? And it's been great since then. So I would say just a year and a half ago, it was just staying consistent. Yeah. And I ain't never been consistent like this since a kid.
Man, listen.
I ain't been consistent like, I had my own class going on a while back, but probably like a year. I did that for like 2 years or a year. But after that, slowed down, you know, they got into other stuff, and other stuff started going on and got distracted. But this time, I ain't letting nothing distract me. I got someplace to be.
I feel you on that. So tell me, like, it's crazy to hear that wake up call moment and literally you just taking that leap of faith. So without there being a typical 9-to-5 of me being in this office or wherever I'm at all day, like when shit is lit, and we all know what our schedules look like when they lit. We busy.
Yeah.
What does a busy day look like for you from start to finish?
A busy day for me, getting up, saying my rituals, my you know, talking to God. I get up and I go work out. That's the first thing I do. I work out, I say my daily affirmations, I say my manifestations, I put it out into the universe. I don't be playing. I do that first. I do that for about like an hour, you know what I'm saying, to start off my day. After that, you know, I get the cleaning up and making my bed and brushing my teeth and washing my face and put my clothes on. And I'ma just give an example from last week. On last Tuesday, that was a very productive day that I had with Miriam and Ashley. So, you know,
shout out to y'all,
the team, the brand. So that particular day, I got ready, I got myself prepared, and went out to Ashley's house, and we stayed shooting for like 6 hours. I was there till like 8 o'clock. I got there like 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I was there about 7 hours. Great, getting great content in. And then from there, I went to dance class, and from dance class, back home. And I just feel like that just makes me happy. Like, that's a busy, productive day for me. Like, even when I don't have a shoot to do, just going to class, doing what I have to do, and coming back home and, you know, winding down. I don't really be out in the streets like that. I don't be outside like that unless it's a celebration. When it's a celebration, then we lit. But just doing what I love to do and then coming home and being tired after what I love to do, that's a great feeling. I feel like I'm accomplished. I'm writing it down in my book. Ooh, got that checked off. Got that done today. And this made me feel so good. Like, I felt so good that day.
I love it. So tell me a little bit, because this is kind of going deep. So I find that people love to say, like, music is a universal language. Food is a universal language. You know, shit like that. But one thing that I don't really hear get mentioned much as a universal language in the same light is dance. I guess maybe educate people on the importance of this shit. Like, I feel like even going back to tribal days, like, fam, we've been doing this shit. We've been doing this shit before anything else. So, like, shit, that's music.
Yeah.
That's before music. So, I guess speak to that a little bit as dance really being shit up there with the other universal languages. Y'all niggas eat shit. You know
it's definitely a language. It's definitely a universal language. Dance itself is an art. Yep. You know, so it depends. It don't matter if you do ballet, hip hop, jazz. You just into, you know, your heels, you're sexy. It's all giving some type of language. It's an emotion, you know? So it's all giving some type of, it's giving the language. It's giving what it's supposed to give. Dance is up there with the others too. Don't play with us.
Especially when I think of like regional dances and stuff like that. Yeah. I'm like, fam, this shit tells a whole story. Just like music, just like food. Like, why don't we talk about that? I guess maybe it's because it's one of them things that everybody can't do, but at the same time, everybody can't cook. Everybody can't make good music, and everybody don't have the best taste in music. It's like, but I'm glad that you shed that light on that, because I do feel that shit is so important, and it's like, nigga,
it's definitely
y'all
art.
Gotta appreciate this.
Yeah, it's definitely art. Please don't take us for granted. It's definitely art, especially when we're the ones. Shout out to Book. She said this a while ago, probably like a week ago. She was like how we was entertaining the world when the world, when we was shut down. Like for the pandemic, we were entertaining. We were,
elaborate on
you know what I'm saying? You know, like the TikToks. I'm getting into the TikToks and things of that nature. But we were entertaining the world, you know what I'm saying? The entertainers, you know, rather than singing, rapping, dancing. We were entertaining while we were in the house for that long period of time, you know? And I feel like that right there gave us a little bit more respect as well, because people that can't even dance gonna wanna get up and do a little, and do a little TikTok. So I feel like we are very entertaining, and it's definitely giving a it definitely gives the language that it's supposed to give. And like I said, from any part of dancing that you do, it definitely gives that, especially if you feeling the dancer, you feeling the music, it's gonna make you wanna get up and like, dang, I think I wanna learn. I wanna do it. It's definitely contagious.
Yeah.
It definitely can be that.
I'm so glad that you brought up like TikTok and just the fact that social media, I promise you, when social media first started, I didn't see dancers as much. Y'all have, first of all, y'all found the right cameraman, and y'all have like catapulted this content shit in a whole nother level. Like these dance videos that I'm seeing now with these cameras and these stabilizers, I'm like, fam, how y'all doing this shit? Like, I gotta better my shit.
It's crazy.
Man, like social media has just changed. I guess tell me, has social media made it kind of easier for as far as like visibility and stuff?
Social media, Instagram, TikTok, all that stuff, you can get noticed and be on tour somewhere just off of just by looking at that type of stuff, just being on that type of stuff and just taking it serious and putting out your content and being consistent.
Yeah.
You can get seen and take off, period. Like, so I feel like that is definitely a platform that us dancers use. Like, that's like the comp card, the business card, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Now, you know, go look on somebody's Instagram and see how consistent they is, and if they're doing, you know, classes, TikToks, or whatever the case may be. Like, that's definitely the place to be. And I'm still building up mine, you know what I'm saying, to this day, but that is definitely, I know some people that don't play about that shit. Like, they don't play. They had three outfits
a whole
in
schedule.
The car. they train, they in different locations. They not playing. And they go home, they edit it, and it be out within 2 to 3 days.
Niggas be editing it in hours.
Yes. It's definitely a blueprint to that social media thing.
Most
with dancers,
definitely.
For sure.
Up in the dark for so long, just living my life on my own. Then right up out of the blue, bumped into you. I was so amused by your smile. me you, hoping you'd be cool while hanging out too. I don't know what happened, got people steady asking how you go to seem mad one day, the next wake up so happy. Love works like magic and it's so true, my mind can't grasp it. I'm just glad that I got you in my life.
So I guess tell me about some of the opportunities, you know what I'm saying, that you've had, some of the stages that you've graced, you know what I'm saying? I follow her on social media, so to my surprise, you know what I'm saying, I just be perusing, you know what I'm saying? I had a friend on the podcast side, he said, she was like, I'm going to the Millennium Tour, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, okay, cool, cool, that's what's up. I look on Deja's Instagram story, I said, oh, you're dancing at the Millennium Tour. What kind of shit is that? Listen, I'm checking in with nothing but greatness, man.
Yeah.
That's all I'm doing. Y'all gonna realize it. But tell us some of the stages you graced.
So, my first big performance that took my career like this was dancing with Usher. I did an audition when I was like 11, 12.
Oh wow, this was long ago.
Yes, this is where it started, and it's so crazy. The area where we are right now is exactly where the audition was. That's why I was like,
wow.
It's crazy that we even here doing our interview here.
That's dope.
So I won that audition, and the prize was to. It's a whole story behind that, y'all. A documentary coming soon. Stay tuned. But it was. I almost got turned around, but I did it because I was so young. But they still let me audition.
Yeah.
And come to find out of those probably 250 dancers, I was the one that won.
Wow.
And the prize was to, you know, what you win is to dance on stage with Usher and be the opening act. And that's at the time where Yeah was popping. Yeah, with him, with Usher, Chris. Not gonna talk about Chris Brown. Usher, Ludacris, and Lil Jon. And they was doing a tour, the Confessions tour, and. To perform here in Atlanta, Georgia at the Phillips Arena. And I opened up with him with Yeah, and that right there was just amazing.
She said that house phone was ringing.
Yeah, like from there it just went skyrocket. I've worked with Sierra. Hey, that's my girl, I love her. I've done Lean With A Rock With It. That's the top thing that everybody know me in. Stuff like that, Promise Ring video. I've danced for Jacob Lattimore. We've done a lot of things, you know, touring and throughout LA. But the most recent one was the Millennium Tour, and that was, it's a full circle moment. And the reason why it was a full circle moment is because I went back to the same arena that I danced with Usher. I'm back there and performed. So that was just touching. That was just,
yeah.
I'm like, God, okay, I hear you, I see you, like,
so you doing
something. You is not playing, and I was crying, I was a crybaby that day, y'all, but I was just so excited, my family was there, it's just different, because I was young, you know, I was in a different headspace, I'm just a young girl, living out my dreams to be back here, grown, and knowing so much more about life now,
wow.
It's just, I was just very emotional. I was a very emotional wreck, but I had a blast sharing the stage with some of the other dancers, and just being able to get back to that, that just let me know I'll never give up. I'll never give up on my dreams and just keep going, because it's bigger to come, for sure.
So you named some good names. If you want to shout out anybody that you want to work with,
Ooh.
Who would that be?
Like,
I need you now.
Well, I know that Lil Baby got a little birthday celebration concert coming up December 12th. So I've been kind of working on trying to get something to do with that. Working with my bro, Sean Bankhead. Shout out to my bro. I'm working with my girl, Bria Woods. Shout out to her. She's working with Sweetie right now. Jeremy Green, I would love to work with him. He's working with Mulatto right now.
Like, got
this. It's just so many people that I can't wait to work with, that I know that it's coming.
I love that.
Just gotta keep prepping and keep prepping and keep doing what I gotta do, and the opportunity will definitely meet that for sure.
That's what it's all about.
Yes.
So I think life is always about paying it forward. Do you ever see yourself in the future doing anything on the giving back scale as far as like having your own studio, having your own space to teach?
Yes, I do want a dance studio. And the way how I envision it is just crazy in my head, but I know it can come true. And I'm definitely gonna shoot to do me a dance studio before I actually sit down, you know, actually retire from dance and stuff like that. But I'm most definitely gonna have my dance studio and, you know, give back. And
do you really see yourself retiring? Because I see, like, shout out Debbie Allen.
Yeah.
People don't even know her dance in history if you just look at her on TV all the time. But, like, that's somebody that I don't see dance ever really. She ain't gonna retire from that shit. Do you see it being like that? Or do you really think it's
what I mean by that is, like, actually getting out there, you know what I'm saying, performing.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? I could put other people in a position to do things like that. You know what I'm saying?
Gotcha.
You know, where I'm just who I am, you know.
Go dance for me.
He crazy. I ain't gonna say it like that. But, you know, put people in a position to, you know, because I was once that girl. So I would want to get other people opportunities and, you know, give them that hope and that, you know that their dreams can come true.
Definitely.
But a dance studio is most definitely coming. And I want to piggyback on what you said about people who I want to work with. I may have named the choreographers, but some more artists that I want to work with is, I'm from Atlanta, so I said, Lil Baby, Thug, Janet Jackson, Chris Brown. Who else is on my list? Like, I got a whole list on my.
Hey, I want a Mario.
See that right there,
man.
That right there went viral.
That's all you get. That's all you get from
that
me.
Right there went viral. Just off of that. That right there went viral. People actually did that for Halloween.
Wait, that's a costume?
Somebody did that for Halloween. That's why. Right, that's how you know.
I'm dressed as the Omarion challenge.
That's just crazy, but that was cool. But yes, I have a lot of dope people I want to work with, and it's soon to come. But to jump back to the dance studio, it's most definitely something that I would love to do. And I'm not going to, what I mean by retire is just like actually sit down and just take care of you know, my kids. A little run, you know what I'm saying? I'm not going to say I'm just going to just bury dance, you know, just as far as like me actually dancing. I may still choreograph or whatever the case may be or have assistance or whatever, but most definitely dance studio. I don't know where it's going to be at, but that motherfucker got to be amazing. Like,
and it will be.
Amazing.
Is there any advice that you would give to anybody that's looking at you and like, damn, I want to get to that point, man. Like, I got to do that. Do you have any advice for that young girl?
Young girl?
Young boy, too. Let me not do that. I'm so sorry.
Tap in some of my fellas, too.
Yeah, niggas is taking over.
Yeah, there's definitely some 5 male dancers out here. All I'm going to say, man, is keep going. This is an industry where it can be dog eat dog. Ain't no it could be. It is dog eat dog world. It's very clicky. You know what I'm saying? So just stay true to you and know who you are and stay at it. You know what I'm saying? If you're young, keep going. And if you're older, still keep going. Just keep going and stay consistent. Consistency is key.
Yeah.
You know? So when you stay consistent, what comes out of that? Don't nothing but good come out of that.
Right.
So just stay consistent. Do what you gotta do. Stay training. Get in these auditions. Get signed. And be that girl or be that guy. And fuck the stages up. You know, have your name ringing bells. Have everybody want to snatch you up and work with you. You know?
Yeah.
Just also, that's my main thing, man. Just keep going. Because I stopped. You know? So you gotta just keep going. You know? You don't want to be that shoulda, woulda, coulda person, you know? So just keep going and live out your dreams, man. It's definitely worth it. It's definitely worth it. That's why I feel like this go around for me is very personal, because I know that when I get back to where I am, I would never, 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 never drop that ball again. I would never, ever, ever drop it, because I know how hard it took me to get back to where I am. So I wish I would let anybody distract me or feel defeated about anything. I'm gonna keep going. So don't never feel defeated. Keep going. You are a star. And just believe that, know that, and claim that all over you from head to toe. You're gonna be all right. Period.
Hey, listen, shit. I be wanting to say all these extravagant ways to exit the show, but listen, I think that's it. Listen, it's another episode of Checking In. I'm so glad I could check in with Daja. She gave me some insight on her. And I hope y'all learn something from it. I hope y'all pick something from it. And listen, for all my ENTREPRENEGROS, if y'all got some shit that y'all got going on, please tap in with me, wimbstudios@gmail.com. I want to interview all you niggas, and make sure you're doing some different shit. Like, I got some really cool things lined up. I really want to show my beautiful black people here in Atlanta in a different light. Everybody don't rap. Everybody don't just make music. It's a lot of shit going on out here that y'all need to tap into. So,
for sure.
Another episode of Checking In. We out.